Module 1, Public Finance. Question number 4. Distinguish between public finance and private finance. Points of distinguish. Number 1, public scrutiny. 2, provision for future. 3, adjustment of income and expenditure. 4, assessment of outcome. 5, magnitude. 6, motives. 7, sources of revenue. 8, sources of borrowing. 9, change in finance. Code to remember these points, palms to C. Point number 1, public scrutiny. In a democracy, every public budget need approval of the elected representatives. Every budgetary decision has to be made known to the public and subject to the constant public scrutiny and evaluation. Generally, individual and household do not prepare budget, and even if they do so, they are not made public. However, business firms may prepare budgets and disclose them to the shareholders. Point number 2, provision for future. The government has to make good provision for the future. It spend large amount of money on development projects such as roads, irrigation projects, power generation, educational institution, health infrastructure, etc., which the future generation would benefit. On the other side, weaker or poorer section of the society and some small business firms find it difficult to generate reserves and surplus for future. Point number 3, adjustment of income and expenditure. A public authority prepares an estimate of the total expenditure to be incurred during the financial year and then decides ways and means to raise the required revenue to finance the expenditure. A public authority adjusts its income to its expenditure. The individual tries to live within his own means. Generally, expenditure is determined by income. Individual and household are governed by satisfaction of want. Depending on the income, expenditure is adjusted. Point number 4, assessment of outcome. The outcome of public financial activities are in terms of social benefit and cost, such as social welfare, social security, law and order, economic growth and development. They all are subjective concepts, and therefore one cannot objectively measure the outcome. The outcome of private finance can be measured in terms of profits or losses of business firm, fulfillment of want, and the level of standard of living. It is easier to measure and evaluate the outcome of private finance. Point number 5, magnitude. Public authorities have huge financial budget for a particular period, which is normally 1 year. For instance, the gross tax revenue of the central government in India for 2014 and 15 was rupees 13.65 lakhs crore budget estimates. However, the financial operation of household and business organization are comparatively smaller in size. Point number 6, motives. Public finance follows the non-profit objectives in framing the budget. Private finance is governed by the profit motive for a business firm and satisfaction of wants for individuals and household. The primary consideration for public authorities is the welfare of the people, and of private business firm is profit. Point number 7, sources of revenue. For public authorities, the sources of revenue are mainly tax, that is direct and indirect tax, and non-tax revenue, that is fees, fines, grants and surplus from PSUs. There is an element of compulsion and no quid pro quo. For individuals and households, the revenue or income can be in the form of salaries or wages, interest and dividends, and other sources. For non-business firms, the revenues can be in the form of fees, grants, and donations. Point number 8. Sources of borrowings. Public authorities can borrow from internal sources such as market loans, bonds, treasury bills, special floatings, special securities issued by RBI, advances from RBI, securities against small savings, and from external sources such as long-term loans from World Bank, IMF, ADB, and other international organizations. The government may also resort to deficit financing. Private parties can borrow funds from internal sources such as friends, relatives, etc., and external sources such as banks and financial institutions. Private parties cannot resort to deficit financing. Point number 9. Changes in finance. Deliberate or major changes are possible in public finance. It is easier for the government to make high and deliberate changes to increase its income as well as expenditure. For an individual or a household or even for a business firm, it is very difficult to make deliberate or major changes to increase or decrease income and expenditure. Let us revise the points once again. 1. Public scrutiny. 2. Provision for future. 3. Adjustment of income and expenditure. 4. Assessment of outcome. 5. Magnitude. 6. Motives. 7. Sources of revenue. 8. Sources of borrowings. 9. Change in finance. Thanks for watching this video. For more videos, please subscribe our channel.